How do I deal with holiday blues, which seem especially pronounced during this pandemic? So many losses. I acknowledge that many people are experiencing lots of loss and lots of pain and lots of challenge on planet Earth. And it's all the more reason to begin to cultivate a capacity to know that this is the finite part of things. And the challenges that we're experiencing all have to do with being in the world and of it, having an identity that's with a human body, in a human life, in a human world, the human condition. Just once in a while, give yourself a break, even if this is hard to believe, even if this is new to you that you don't entirely resonate with, or maybe you have never resonated with being a divine being. You were before you were born, and you will be after you leave this planet. There's no annihilating the truth of you. It's immortal and impeccably perfect. And if you could just for a moment step outside of yourself and outside of this finite world and these limitations and challenges that you have and that you're feeling, and let yourself move into a place where maybe it isn't so much a loss, but it's a shift and a change. And what we do to ride out shifts and changes the most easily and effortlessly is we shift our perception to move along with the changes and the shifts that are happening. So right now, it might appear like we're having a lot of losses, but what if for the person who or the beings who have left, for them, it's just like opening a door and going into another room. They're in another experience. And this is a never-ending experience. Our huge, vast capacity and eternal nature just shifts from place to place and situation to situation. And sometimes when a situation becomes untenable or unbearable, it's a lot more fun and interesting and enticing to just move into another situation. Now, we on planet Earth don't necessarily like that idea that people leave and that there it feels like we have a lot of losses of all kinds, that not just people, but situations change. And we want things to kind of stay the same, to be safe, to be happy. Well, we all know at the same time that that's an impossibility, that things will change and shift and expand. And when we begin to not only just accept that or tolerate that, but love that, that that actually means that there'll always be, and then there's this to the story, that things will change, this too shall pass, then the only thing missing in that equation is the fact that your vision has to become more expansive and capable of seeing that the and then there's this is always expanding into a and then there's this is even better than this. So I know a lot of people can find that hard to resonate with that idea because they feel in a world where you're oriented towards loss as your perception rather than gain in changes. You're going to have to really take this in a personal way and bring it home and let yourself sit with things. It's easiest when you're feeling a little bit more peaceful. So when you have an immediate loss, sometimes it's very hard to see the grace in the situation. Let yourself just go to a place that feels more peaceful, maybe sit under a tree if the weather's fine, or go to a place where you feel more peace and spaciousness. Embrace yourself where you are. Let yourself first get into a place where you're being kind to yourself or looking for ways that you can resonate with something that already is inherently peaceful, a happier person that you're friends with, you know, being in situations where there feels like there's a little bit of a levity and delight at hand. When you're in that place where you're feeling a little bit of a sense of relief, and really look for these places, even on planet Earth, you know, the finding yourself, you know, with flowers or something that can feel as though it's bringing you to a state of equanimity and peace, even temporarily. Then begin to let yourself know and feel, and then there's this, and then there's this, and begin to move into a more expansive state. Remembering these little delightful times or scenarios that you can identify with without too much challenge or too much problem, accepting them and embracing them, they're kind of a doorway into a place where you can actually sit with the things or the challenging feelings that feel like losses or hardships, and just let yourself leave space around them. It's literally like you're not becoming tight or too stuck on any one position that feels painful inherently. You're letting yourself loosen it up and finding space within the experience. The easiest way is to just allow yourself to breathe into the stuck places within you that you'll actually feel. Maybe feel heavy-hearted or like you have a twisted knot in your gut. Just let yourself begin to notice very deliberately and peacefully and presently that you can add space. And then begin to let yourself identify more with the space than the opinion or the feeling or the judgment. Just know that space is the healing balm. That the more you can identify with the space between the thoughts or the challenging situation, your idea about the challenging situation, just breathe deeply and identify with the space. Then just ask for a shift in perception. That's all it takes. It doesn't take for the whole situation to change immediately, just the shift in perception. The access to heaven or the access to peace comes from within us because it's a shift in perception. Whenever you can allow for a shift to happen, you're allowing for the broader, more vast perspective to dawn. You'll find that there's peace inherent in that. Go easy on yourself. Be kind to yourself. That's the main thing. And then you'll start to see that things change around you as you begin to resonate more with peaceful, more loving thoughts and experiences for yourself.